comes to us from Hinesville, Arkansas, the 38 of Levi Henderson. Scotty Cook with heat race number 4 winner Levi Henderson.
Alright, everybody, welcome back to the channel. This week is the Keith Kunz Motorsports Giveback Classic. It's currently Friday, our preliminary night. They ran on Thursday, that was the first prelim night, and then we got elected to run on Friday. But everybody's getting ready for hot laps. We're gonna go out and hot lap, and then we're doing single car qualifying after that. I drew a 74, and out of 48 cars, I am the last car to go out in qualifying. So that just shows how many people I gotta beat in qualifying. But first we're gonna rip in hot laps, and then do a few last minute adjustments for qualifying. So y'all stay tuned, ought to be a fun night. 48 non-wing outlaw micros checked in, and then yeah. We'll just go see if we can make our preliminary A-Main. So, y'all ride along, it ought to be a good one.
Two-tenths of a second to get the top spot. Andriotti, not going to do it. He'll stay six quick on the field.
Next driver, our final driver in line here to take time, comes to us from Hinesville, Arkansas, the 38 of Levi Henderson. Henderson works down into turn number 3, lap number 1 for the 38. We'll go 19th quick, a 10.958, a 10.958 for Levi Henderson. Looking for some improvement here out of turn number 4. Does he have any more in the tank? He does not there, just a tick slower, however. 19th quick overall for Levi Henderson.
Well, fellas, after hot laps and qualifying, hot laps was a complete dud, complete waste. Track was still so soupy, it had a glaze of water over it, so no traction whatsoever. But, we drew the last number for going out for qualifying, the 48th car. And we come around and put that sucker 19th on the board. So, we made the invert, and that means we're starting first inside front row in heat race number 4. So, we're gonna run the bottom. They're reworking the racetrack. Dad's got the setup dialed in. We are gonna motor on the bottom and make them suckers go around us, if they even are gonna get to go around us. So, y'all stay tuned. Hopefully this heat race goes well. Sorry I didn't have no end car from qualifying, but you got the Flow Racing broadcast. But what do you think, Dad?
Well, we've got to make 8 good laps. We're going to make them go around us, because I think the car will roll on the bottom good.
I think he's right. So,
we'll go see.
We're going to finish up our little last-minute changes. Then I'm going to hop in and go rip for 8. Hopefully we can win ourselves a heat race, and to do it at the KKM would be really sick. So, we'll see what happens.
We want them side by side at the line out of turn number 4. On the throttle, we go green out of turn number 4.
It's another one of those races, or another one of those cars, I should say. Your quick qualifier out of this group, Justin Simpson, another one running a stock power plant underneath the hood. Trying to make it happen out here as he slings it up on the high side. Unfortunately, drops back a position. as they race down into turn number one and two, three wide for fourth on the field.
Well, that's one thing about Justin Simpson. He is not afraid to go up top and try to just get that momentum, get that thing wound up. Now he'll look through the middle, now down to the bottom, looking to the inside of Connor Lee. Connor Lee going to try and roll the middle up to the top side of the racetrack. Not going to quite work just yet. It's Crabtree going to hold on to that third spot.
Yeah, Lee's kind of caught out there, so he's going to have to make it work or try to get himself down to the inside. He continues to persist, however, with a deep run down into turn number three as he looks around the outside. The 88 down with Crabtree. Crabtree down on the inside, working that third spot. Fourth is right back behind, now looking to the outside one more time.
Four laps in the books. Margaret, five laps in the books this time by, and it's still Connor Lee trying to bang the boards to get around that 88M and Max Crabtree. They go side by side down the back straightaway into turn number three. Connor Lee going to have the spot taken away from Crabtree with two laps remaining here in heat race number four for the non-wing outlaw division.
That outside line comes in. It's all going to be because of Connor Lee. He's making it work now. Gets second away from the 87 of Max Leppard as they crossed over the stripe. Can he get the number one spot? White flag has flown. That is a large deficit to run down, but he's going to give it a shot.
He closes the gap, and it's going to be too much, too late there for the 1H of Connor Lee. It's going to be the 38 of Levi Anderson, your race winner. Connor Lee going to finish in the second spot of Max Leppard. So Levi Henderson going to make his way down to Scotty Cook. Scotty Cook with heat race number four winner, Levi Henderson.
High side Levi Henderson picking up a big heat four win, buddy. I know that feels fantastic knowing full well coming in here how stout this finale field is this weekend.
Oh, yeah, man, I tell you. Hang on, let me get my helmet off for you. Oh, man, I tell you what, get my first career heat race win here at Port City, and to do it at the KKM feels pretty special. And Dad had this thing on rails, so we're going to go back and get ready for this qualifier.
You'll be a welcome addition to the field if you can wheel that thing to a big qualifier finish, and we'll be watching, buddy. Great job.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right, here's out of the state of Arkansas, Levi Henderson, Heat 4 winner. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Scotty. The final heat race of the night for the non-wing outlaw micros brought to you by Driven Midwest. Heat race number 5 lines up like this on the pole.
Well, fellers, how about that one?
Won ourselves a freaking heat race. I am absolutely ecstatic. I don't know if you could tell in my interview that I was out of breath, but that was pretty freaking dope. 1-1 in the heat race. We start second in qualifier number 4. 10 laps. Hang on, brain fart. 10 cars, 10 laps, and we're just getting more points. What's up, Riker? What do you think?
Good. Heat race from last.
Well, guess what? I won my freaking heat race. How about that?
Yeah.
But yeah, qualifier's up next. We gotta wait, and then we'll go see what happens. Got a pretty stacked qualifier. Got Chris Carroll and Macintosh behind me. So
subscribe.
Yeah, what he said.
Your top three.
Things will get decidedly tougher for Kenan McIntosh. He moves into the number three spot and falls Carroll down into turn number one and two. Back behind, slide jobs galore, and crossovers to be found as well. Dysinger and Brody going at it.
Dysinger clears them all. It's going to be Brady Henderson now going to work as Leighton Pearson to the inside of the 38 takes away the spot. They're three wide. Look out. Oh, boy, that was almost big. Down into turn number three.
Yeah, for taking that shot on the side there for the number 38 car, Levi Henderson, he got very lucky. That thing was lofted up into the air, and it could have been over, but was fortunate enough to land and just kind of spin around backwards. But you're right, that could have been worse.
didn't go very good. Kind of set the car up to run the bottom because I thought the bottom would still be there, but boy was I wrong. Oh, top was there, car couldn't get around it very well, and we got put up in the wall, and the starter went out after we slammed back down, spun out. But I cranked it on the track, and it came back to life pretty quickly. And then when I got back in here, rolling into the pits, it stopped, or it died, and then it wouldn't crank back over. So I think our starter went out, but luckily I can push start the car. So we'll go out here in this B main. We start fourth, they take the top three, got some fast guys, but we're just gonna go have some fun. Got a little beat up tonight, but all in all, it was pretty fun. Kind of went backwards in our B, didn't set the car up correctly for the racetrack that we were given. Sorry, we got cars rolling by. But all in all, pretty fun. I was right there at the beginning, was running fourth, and then we should have had less air pressure and set it up to run around the bottom a lot better. But won a heat race at the KKM Giveback Classic, stock motor, kicked all the outlaw guys' butts. So we'll come back tomorrow and run the soup. I don't know where we're gonna be, probably a C. Hopefully the back of a B, that'd be really nice. But all around a pretty good night, just kind of upset we had some bad luck. But we're gonna get it to Jill's tomorrow. We're gonna put a new starter in it, and then we're gonna wash it up, make her nice and shiny and clean, and come back do it again. So I'll see y'all in the morning. We're gonna finish loading up, watch the prelim A for Friday night, which is tonight, and then head on to Jill's.
What do you think on what are your thoughts on the night, Dad?
Yeah, I just wish we'd have done a better job keeping up with the track. Because the car is fast and you were driving it good, we just missed it just a little bit. So yeah, I mean that qualifier, we got roughed up pretty good, so ran over. But yeah, we'll put a starter in it. I don't want to push starter anymore. We'll get after it tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh yeah, these additional nodes right here. Look at that. First heat race win at the biggest race of the year. My personal opinion, it's bigger than the shootout, just because it pays a lot more and there's a lot more on the line. But that's just my opinion. Y'all can hate me in the comments, but whatever. So, with that being said, without further ado, I will see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.
Day number two, championship night of the Keith Kunz Motorsports Giveback Classic here at Port City. Last night was pretty decent, not bad. We accumulated enough points to be starting eighth in the second C feature. So they take the top four from the C to the back of the B. And I don't know what to expect, really. I think everybody's going to be going for broke. So if we're just smart, go where they're not, try to go forward, I think we ought to be really good. But hot laps are fixing to begin, so I'm going to jump in my suit and get all my stuff together, and we're going to go hot lap. Hopefully the track's a little better tonight for hot laps than it was last night because it was bad shoopy. But hopefully they got a little more run in and more cars on the track today. Everybody's running instead of split fields. So hopefully the track's a little bit better and we can, you know, rip tonight. So y'all stay tuned for the finale of the KKM Giveback. Hopefully it's a good one, and hopefully we put on a show. Super juiced up, and it still is, even though we're like halfway through the program. But we start eighth in this C feature. Track is one lane around the bottom, so we're just gonna, you know, elbows up, see how many spots we can get, and we'll see what happens. So y'all ride along. Hopefully we can park it in the top four and transfer onto the B main. But if not, we're just gonna go have some fun.
Well,
unfortunately, our night came to an end in the B or the C, whatever it was. Track was freaking one lane around the bottom and you couldn't pass. Started 8th, finished 8th. Car was really good though. I mean, it drove great, had a lot of power. I was right there with the guys in front of me, just single file train around the bottom. It's no fun. But all in all, I think we had a pretty solid weekend. Car ran good, it drove good. We won ourselves a heat race here at Port City, and to do it at the KKM Giveback Classic is pretty freaking dope. So I think we've got one more race this year in the micro. It'll be the Fall Brawl in November. But in the meantime, we'll probably do some kart racing, so y'all stay tuned for that. I couldn't do this, be here, without any of my amazing sponsors. First off, gotta thank, you know, my mom and dad. They support my dreams. They let me come do this on the weekends, and they're behind me every step of the way. My sister, my girlfriend Abby, grandma and grandpa, they support me. And then we got the amazing sponsors you get to see on the car: RSR Excavation, Valley Fertilizer, Mine Right Logistics, Fast Automotive, Taylor Racing Engines, Speed Stick Shocks, Max Pepis Innovations, Fuel Tech, The Computer Under the Hood, K1 Speed, JG, Raceworks, Velocita. Just a lot of great people we get to work with and go get to do what we love to do on the weekends. So, without further ado, I'm going to leave the KKM video here. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe. Hopefully this video does good and we can get to 1,000 subscribers before December 31st. That'd be really nice to hit, but thank you all so much for the support, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Yo. 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 Yo.
Chick I call it Lola, she feel like the ocean, like to drink and smoke some Doja, and I feel like smoking, plus she good at charming Cobra.